Hi guys, and in this video I will show you how to install some visual mods to KSP 1.4.1. Before we start, I want to say that if you have any problems with my English, or I will be showing something very fast, or it will be unclear for you, I will also have text tutorial on my website, and link will be in the video description. Or you can try to read English captions, which will be available. So I already made installation guide for version 1.3 and 1.3.1, which were extremely successful videos. But hopefully, this will be even better. So I tested this on KSP version 1.4 and also 1.4.1 with DLC/expansion, and everything was working fine. So to start, open up KSP installation directory. On Steam, you can do it by right-clicking to KSP, then Properties, Local Files and Browse Local Files. This should open up your KSP installation directory. If you have it installed somewhere else, just skip this step. To install mods into KSP, all you have to do is just copy downloaded mod inside the game data directory. So let's start by downloading first mod called Scatterer, which will add some awesome looking fog, reflection of water with waves and much more. So if you have it downloaded, you will now need something which can work with archives, for example WinRAR or 7-zip. So open up that downloaded Scatterer file and copy inside of this folder into the KSP game data directory. Next up will be mod SVE or Stock Visual Enhancements. So download the base mod along with textures. From SVE textures you can choose between high, medium or low resolution textures. Then you will also need to download EU or environmental visual enhancements, but do not download configs. There are config files already in Scatterer. So if you will download and use both, you will end up with overlaying textures and very bad performance. But if you will don't have any clouds after I will show you all these steps, you can try downloading EU with configs. It may fix the clouds in some cases. So let's install these mods. First one will be EU. Again, open it up and extract its content inside the KSP game data directory. Do the same thing for the SVE and SVE textures, as you can see on the video. Next mod will be Texture Replacer, which was surprisingly updated, and we will be using it for changing the skybox. So download it from GitHub, then open up and extract it into KSP game data directory. For that better skybox, I will be using Rareden's Real 8K Skybox. You can download it from Dropbox, also link will be in the video description. If you want to use different skybox, you can, but you need .jpeg or .png file types. From what I know, Texture Replacer will not work with, for example, .dds files. There is also another skybox mod available, but as I said, it was not working for me. But you can give it a shot. To install it, copy all photos from that skybox inside the KSP Texture Replacer default folder, as I did. Next up we have Galileo Sun Flares, which will make the sun, or in KSP Kerbal, looks much more better, and you will also have that nice realistic lens flare effect. To download it, you can choose from a lot of different colors, and then just extract it into game data directory as every other mod. Now let's install mod Copernicus, which is for modifying planet textures and other stuff. Again, download it and then extract everything to game data directory. To install planet or terrain textures, download SVT or Stock Visual Terrain and extract it inside the game data folder. Now if you want some realistic engine effects, you can install mod Real Plume along with Smokescreen. But the new KSP 1.4 with updated Unity particles is already very good, so it is optional if you want to use it. But to install it, download the latest Real Plume and Smokescreen and extract everything from Real Plume to game data directory, but from Smokescreen extract only Smokescreen and Smokescreen stock. Do not extract Real Plume from Smokescreen because it is outdated. Another mod called Raster Probe Monitor will make cockpits look much better and it will add functional displays. Installation is again the same. Extract the JSI folder to game data directory. To improve stock part textures, you can use this quite old mod called Stock Part Revamp. And surprisingly, version for KSP 1.2 is still working totally fine even on 1.4.1. So download it and now pay attention, because from my old video I know that this mod was causing a lot of problems, because it was not installed properly. So when you will download it, inside stockpart revamp master folder is folder game data. Ignore all other folders and files. Only one important is game data, which you need to copy into KSP installation game data folder. And now you should be done with the installation. Now I like to launch KSP from launcher only for the first time to set graphic preset to maximum. And then you must use 64-bit KSP launcher called KSP-X64 located in the installation folder, or you can just use Steam and select 64-bit version during the launch. If you will don't use 64-bit version, your game will be probably crashing or it will don't work at all. If you did everything correctly, now you should have awesome looking Kerbal Space Program. I want to mention that all new parts even from DLC are working totally fine. So you can still change the color of new parts. Only one thing is that the new RCS tank was totally changed and the old textures from stock part revamp mod was not made for that. To fix it, you can remove large RCS tank texture from stock part revamp mod inside your game data. I also tried playing the first mission with these mods and it was working totally fine. So I hope that this video was much better than the previous visual mods tutorial on my channel. If you have any questions or problems, I will try to help you in the comment section, or you can visit my Discord server and I will be glad to help you. If you want to see more content from me, you can check out my latest mission from building the ultimate space station around the cabin, or visiting all Easter eggs video, which on both I was using these visual mods. Thanks for watching and bye!